Bang, Neeves Knives. I'm Jared with my lovely wife, Kara.
Hey guys!
So, I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, first up, you kind of want to get somewhat of a balanced knife. There are going to be some knives that are better than others at spinning and flipping. And there are a lot more different techniques, some more dangerous than others. The one I'm doing here is, like, you know, it's not really safe, but it's not very dangerous either. You want to make sure your edge isn't extremely sharp, just in case. But a little bit more of a straighter design might help you at first. But it's, you know, after you get it down, it's really not going to matter what knife you have. You can even do it with smaller knives. You just have to position your hands differently. So let's get started. And in a moment, I'll show it on another knife just in case if that helps at all. Okay, so first up, you want to be able to do this, where you just take the knife and pinch it right there. So pinch it, and that's going to let you spin it. You're not going to have to worry about spinning it if you start off with the edge towards you, because when you spin it, it's going to hit you on the spine, okay? Then you have to know how to spin a knife. So you might want to just practice this a little bit. And when you get really good, you can spin it and flip it backwards at the same time, like that. But don't start off by doing that. Just try to make it line up, like, directly. And you can do it by just laying your head flat and giving it just a little bit of momentum like this and keeping your thumb out of the way. This is pretty controllable. I started off when I was a kid doing it with remote control. So if you have a remote control, I mean, you can maybe try with that. But a knife's not really that dangerous to do this with, especially if the edge isn't that sharp. And most people can do this. You just kind of give it a little pop at the same time, because when it spins, you're going to have your hands to stop it, basically. And you'll feel it after a while where it's going to lay in position. Now, the tough part. So after you get this part down, where you spin it, spin, spin it, spin, pinch, over the clip and over the spine, flip, spin. Now, if you get into a time where you go to spin it like this, because this happens sometimes, where you go to do this, and instead what happens is it hits right there. Okay, you're going to pop it back and just hurry up and pinch it again, but just a little lower. So that'll happen. Sometimes you'll accidentally grip it in a higher spot, and you'll go like this, and it'll get caught. So then you just smack it back. And really quick. And you'll get used to repositioning that really very fast, where you, you know, it won't go, and you just smack it back and back. Trying to do it slow. It's kind of hard to do some of this slow because you don't have the momentum you need. Now, next part. Pinch. Drag your middle finger over, okay? And you're also going to want to have a certain position of the knife after a while. You kind of get used to that. Pinch it, drag your middle finger over. Now you're going to direct it with your middle finger this way. Now you're going to want to be in a position that this next part doesn't leave you up here. So pinch, spin, and then get your next finger, or your ring finger there. Bam. Single really quick. Bam, bam. Then you're going to have it basically like this. And that same time, you're going to do that same pinch we talked about in the beginning. Bam. Right there. And it's going to swing forward, back, spin. So let's do it again. You hold it like this. Middle finger over, middle finger over, spin, spin, then pinch, pinch, flip, flip, and then Sometimes also when you're doing it, you're going to get to a spot where it hits right here, basically. So you just kind of got to get used to manipulating your hand like this, like letting it flip. See how the butt is flipping towards me? So it flips towards me and I grab it. And then sometimes it might also hit right here when you're trying to do the flip right here. It might hit here. And same thing as the other way, you just smack it back. So like, say if it hits there and I can't flip it now, I'll just send it back this way and then reposition my fingers. So instead of being like this, I'll reposition them like this and then it can swing. So again, pinch, flip, flip, pinch, spin, spin, flip. And like I said, you're going to have to move your hands a little bit like this to control it, you know, in a side-to-side motion. So right now, I'm here, right? So now I'm going to flip it up, back, forth. It's pretty easy. Let's go over it again, really slow. So you're holding it, flip your middle finger over. You got it right here like this. You're gonna spin it. Spin, pinch, flip, spin, ring finger. Now you're stuck like this. So now there's actually a couple ways you can get by doing this, but I'm just going to try to teach you as basic as possible. You're just flipping up, back, over, up. And then you see how I'm going like this, and then I'm flicking this way. It's giving me the handle. And then here's another knife, just in case if it helps easier. And this one's a little heavier and larger, but it still has decent balance. This one's probably not the best one to practice on, just because you have these little nubs and stuff. They don't really get in the way too much, but that one I messed up on. I'm not even sure I can do this little one. I wasn't planning on doing a smaller one, but usually with a smaller one, you have to go down at the end of the knife, like down here, like not in the middle. You start off, well, first off, make sure you can do this with it, because that's probably going to be the tough part. But flip, 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 flip. Flip, 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 flip. You see me improvise a little bit with this one in some areas. And at the very least, knowing how to do this is very important in my opinion. Now, I've ran in times where I've had to do that. And not even like dangerous situations or anything, just where like I'm working or something like that, and maybe I pick up the knife, right? Like I'm like my eyes are focused on something and I grab my knife and it's already open or something, so I grab it like this. So And I just flip it really quick, you know, instead of setting it back down and switching hands. And it makes you a little bit better with hand and eye coordination. And like I said, I do it all the time. Like, I'll be working and I'll be cutting something up and, you know, who knows, whatever the situation is, like, I run into it where sometimes I have to do that. Or even just handing it to somebody, you know, just then handing it off. I know it's easy to also just go like this and hand it off, but that's the same thing, though, knowing how to, you know, just manipulate your knife a little bit. But there's also situations where, I mean, I wouldn't say it's very good for, like, self-defense or anything like that, but it's fun to just play around. But oh, you can use your imagination. But there you guys go. Hopefully I'll be able to slow it down and break it down good enough when I edit this. Thanks, guys. Peace.